academic departments and instructors. Then APA formats American psychology sources within the social sciences used by the various other scientific journals, including medical and public health journals, textbooks, and academia. Then ACM format, Association for Scientific and Industrial Computer Society, where they publish their own journal or proceedings. Then I have showed here basically what is the difference basically the APA format that I have showed here. The paper size, what is the paper size, then page margin, font spacing, alignment of text, paragraph identification of sentence, then page number, all this I have made it comparable, so you can go that and you can see it. Then different and also section headings that I have showed here, what is the difference between these two guidelines. And also tables and instructions too. And also what are the major section, then bi-section that I have also showed here, how both styles are also showing difference from each other. Then also bibliography. Bibliography is a list of the sources used to get information for your report. As a rule of academic writing, students need to admit the truth when they use other people's ideas, views, data, information, written materials, audiovisual resources, etc. When you use a direct quotation or profit section, follow cite the sources and no bibliography truth secret. It intends to tell reader about accuracy, value, and relevancy of the sources. That I have also showed here MLA format and also APA format in the context of the books. That means author's last name, first name, book title, additional information, city of publication, publishing company, publication date. So here what it happens in the MLA format, here usually comes at the end. But in the APA format, we can see from here that author's last name, then initial, first initial, publication date, then book title, additional information, city of publication, publication company. So these are the basically two difference in the MLA format. Here is at the last of the sentence, and in the APA format, after the surname, then first name, within bracket, there is also the year. So these are the basically differences between the MLA format and the APA format. Then I have showed is also in the case of the encyclopedia and dictionary, what should be the format to write, that I have also showed here. Then also magazine and newspaper articles in the MLA format and also APA format that I have also showed here. Then also grammar checking. Next part is I will discuss, there are several notes are discussed here. The top 10 most popular online grammar and punctuation checkers. Grammar and punctuation check tools highlights grammatical mistakes in your text and give suggestions to improve the content. The tools are also rectify issues in punctuations to make the messages clear and to improve readability. These tools help transform your thoughts and ideas into perfectly crafted pieces that are devoid of grammatical errors, typos, and punctuation errors. So if you do not have the luxury to hire an editor or a proofreader, you can rely on this best grammar checker tools to help you choose the right one. We have reviewed the top 10 grammar checking software available online. First is the Pro Writing Aid. The tool is a grammar check online style editor and writing mentor in all, not all, does it help you writing grammatically correct content. But it also removes errors along with the way. With Pro Writing Aid, your writing will never be clumsy or awkward. The tool will analyze your writing to eliminate any inconsistencies, vague words, repetitiveness, correct use of voices, etc. Pro Writing Aid does all this by generating 25 writing reports, written writing style grammar, overcast, words, silences and redundancies, sticky sentences, repeats, sentence lengths, pronouns, then transitions, consistency, pacing, dialogue, text, readability, vague and abstract words, thesaurus, dictation, alliterations, then homonymous, then corporate wording, acronyms, then complex words, then eloquence, combo, house style, and plagiarism. It is then OpenOffice, Google Docs, Scrivener, and Google Chrome, so you can easily edit whenever you write. So these are the one, and the main feature is also contextual thesaurus report, Mac and Windows support, integration with all major writing platform, Word Explorer, detailed error explanation, context sensitive style suggestions. Then second is the Grammarly. Grammarly is one of the most popular grammar checkers out there, use millions of people. It offers free online text editor and free browser extension to Chrome and Firefox. It can fix over 150 types of errors from your writings when you automatically. Grammarly detects errors such as punctuation, grammar, writing styles, contextual spelling, and sentence structure. For all your mistakes, Grammarly will give you an explanation of what you did wrong and offer to replace errors. It supports different writing styles, including blog posts, business texts, academic writings, and also supports both British and American English. If you use subject-specific words that are not recognized by Grammarly online, you can add them to the dictionary so that they don't get flagged the next time. Then what is the key feature? Performance stats, then plagiarism detector, vocabulary enhancement suggestions, desktop and mobile apps, generate specific writing style checks. White smoke effort in you take for error smoke will start red you have your writings. Things just in time is sentence of session fix your writing, but it's a suggestion of writing needs improvements. It is one of the best software sentence spelling. You won't have to cut and paste lines of text from one program to another to the next is another online grammar.
So you can use
another online grammar checking your text. Yeah, I have done.
Thank you.
I have done. Yeah. apart from checking your text or errors, white smoke will also generate. And that will review and rate your writings. Rating is just in six categories: sentence structure, words, expressions, length, and redundancy. Not only you can fix your writings, but it also gives you suggestion on where writing needs improvement. Then it is one of the best software for grammar checking, syntax, and spelling error. Also does all these things.